Some such at the Gusset, threat to smoking on Cedar Rapids golf courses on hold. 2015年7月11日 Rick Smith source, the Gusset, Cedar Rapids, Iowa July 11, Cedar Rapids, taking on the city's golfers can seem like the third rail of local elective politics. On a beautiful Friday morning at the Ellis Golf Course, there was not a golfer to be found who had much good to say about a city proposal to impose a ban on smoking on the four city round golf courses. "Smoking on the golf course doesn't bother me," said non-smoker John Norris of Cedar Rapids as he finished his early morning round of golf with five others. "A ban would be ridiculous. I wouldn't vote for anyone running for city council who voted for a ban. If they want to worry about something, lower the prices, do something constructive for the golf course, let them worry about that." In late May, the city's Parks, Waterways and Recreation Commission voted Goldseelingtai recommend that the city ban the use of tobacco, nicotine and electronic vaporizers from city parks, trails and golf courses. At the time, Jackie Thompson Astor, the commission chairwoman, said the commission did discuss an exception for golfers at one point, but then set the idea aside. A unanimous commission recommendation often makes its way in quick fashion to the city council for a vote, but that is not the case with the proposed ban that includes golf courses. The department and the city are looking deeper into the question of whether to include the city's golf courses in a smoking ban in parks. Sven Leff, the city's Parks and Recreation Director, said this week. Anecdotally, the feedback from the golfers has been primarily opposed to such a ban. Blue Zones initiatives, the metro area drive behind the smoking ban in park areas in Cedar Rapids and Marion, has come from the Blue Zones health initiatives in both communities. The Marion City Council finalized the smoking ban in its parks and on its trails in early May, a ban set to go into effect later this year. However, Cedar Rapids Mayor Ron Corbett on Friday said Marion's very aggressive smoking ban came without any golfers to contend with because Marion does not have a city round course, so Cedar Rapids can't mirror what Marion did because it's not the same. "Our proposal includes golf courses," the mayor said. For now, Corbett said the proposed ban is on hold for the rest of the year. "We have a lot of street needs, and there's been some gunfire in the city," he said. "The last thing we need to do is put cigar smoking on the golf courses front and center on our agenda." Cedar Rapids City Council member Emporza Godolfer and said Friday she is a strong supporter of the city's Blue Zones initiative, but not when it comes to a smoking ban on golf courses. She said, "I don't want to get crosswise with Blue Zones, but I think this goes too far," Paul said. "Golfers are so far away from each other when they play that I can't imagine smoking impacting anyone. I think a ban is announced at a," Mate Wagner, a golfer, a former City Parks Commission and former City Council member who is running for an at-large seat on the council this year, said this week that he wasn't sure smoking ban on golf courses was the way to go either. Even so, he said the litter of cigarette and cigar butts on courses does bother him. "Those things don't disintegrate for some years," he said of cigarette butts. At the Ellis course, Barry Criddle of Cedar Rapids said he didn't like a lot of rules, and he said the cigar while playing golf is a tradition of sorts, not unlike a beer and a cigar while fishing. "Are you going to be able to smoke, drink beer and fish?" he said. Perry Cadu of Cedar Rapids said a ban on smoking on golf courses was unenforceable, so why bother with it? "What's the big deal?" said Craig Pilcher of Central City. "So what if they have a cigar? You're out in the open. It's leisure. It's their fun." Dick Pilcher of Robbins said the day is coming when the only place to smoke will be in your own backyard. Norris, Ron Russell and Lee Killerhills of Cedar Rapids wondered where the city's Gusinator was, referring to the city's robot-controlled deck noise that have run defecating these away from the riverfront amphitheater and golf courses. "Last year, it worked," Norris said. "This year, these fesses are all over our carts, shoes and bags." Copyright. C. 2015 The Gazette, Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Visit The Gazette, Cedar Rapids, Iowa, at The Gazette.com. Distributed by Tribune Content Agency, LLC.